So in the previous class, we had discussed about the land pollution and we had started the water pollution and its causes. So now we will discuss about the effects of water pollution. So polluted water is very important for the survival of a life. So polluted water is harmful for both plants and animals. Plants die if polluted water reaches their roots, and animals will also die if they drink the polluted water. So polluted water is harmful for both plants and animals. Harmful substances present in polluted water decrease the amount of oxygen present in water. So aquatic animals and plants, they also die because they do not get sufficient oxygen to survive. So because of that also plants and animals die. So sometime animals, those who are living inside the water, swallow the garbage which we throw in the water. They swallow it and then they die due to the choking on the garbage, because they can't digest the garbage, but still we are throwing the garbage into the water, and the aquatic organism or the animals, those who are living inside the water, they swallow it and then they die due to the choking on garbage. So polluted water leads to disease such as diarrhea and typhoid. Because of the polluted water, disease takes place like diarrhea and typhoid. So industries should treat wastewater and then release it into the water bodies to prevent the water pollution. So for prevention of water pollution, the industries, they should treat the wastewater and then they release it into the water bodies. We should avoid wasting water. We should avoid washing clothes, and we should avoid bathing in rivers and ponds. We should not throw the garbage waste near the water bodies such as sea beaches and river banks. They get washed away into the water, and then the organisms or the animals which live inside it, they swallow it and then they die. So we must not throw the garbage waste near the water bodies. We should not take bath in the water bodies. We should avoid washing clothes and all in the water bodies to prevent the water pollution, so that we can to a small extent we can prevent the water pollution. So we should protect the environment. We can protect our environment by planting more and more trees. The best way to protect the environment is to plant more and more trees. The process of planting trees in areas that have been deforested or have fewer trees, that is known as afforestation. The cutting down of trees is called deforestation and the planting of trees is called afforestation. So this afforestation helps in preserving the habitat of animals, and it also prevents soil erosion. So preserving our existing forest and preventing them from being cut down, it helps us to protect our environment. Secondly, we must not throw the plastic bags in drains, because they block the drains and they stop the passage of dirty water. Because of the plastics and all, the drains are getting blocked and the dirty water is not able to pass. So we must not throw the plastic bags in the drains. We must not dump the electronic waste like TV, battery, cell phone and computers. The materials of electronic waste are extremely hazardous to the environment. That means they are very dangerous for the environment. So the dry waste such as papers, plastic and bottles, and wet waste such as fruit and vegetable peels, residual food items are disposed of separately. Like you can see, there are nowadays two bins are used. One is for the dry waste and one is for the wet waste. So here dry waste like paper, plastic and bottles can be dumped, and here wet waste like fruit, vegetable peels, residual food items should be disposed of separately. So we should be aware of our duty to preserve the environment. So that is why slowly people all over the world are gradually becoming aware of the duty or to preserve the environment. And in 1972, United Nations General Assembly decided to dedicate a day or to raise environmental awareness. To raise awareness for the environment, a day is dedicated by the United Nations General Assembly to encourage the actions to protect the environment. To protect the environment, a day was raised, and the United Nations has declared 5th June as World Environment Day. So this day is celebrated as World Environment Day, and this is the given by, this is declared by United Nations. These are the three effective ways: reduce, reuse, recycle. These are the most effective ways through which we can save natural resources and protect our environment. These three are the important ways to protect the environment: reduce, reuse, recycle. So reduce means we should reduce waste generation. We should reduce waste generation as much as possible. Reuse means we should reuse the things in different ways rather than throwing them. Instead of throwing, we can use them, we can reuse them in different ways. Then we should recycle the things used or use recyclable things. If possible, we can recycle the used things or we can use the recyclable things. So that these three are the effective ways through which we can save our natural resource. So this is all about our environment and pollution and how to prevent pollution and to protect the environment. Next class I will give you the question answer, write them and learn them.